Hello and welcome to Pet Pals. I'm Bethany Davidson, the humane educator here at Frederick County Animal Control and Pet Adoption Center. And today our animal wrangler, Randy Cooper, is outnumbered on the dog portion of our show because we are featuring all female dogs today. And
works
first up is Tasha. I recently was able to take Tasha out to an event. We went to the FCC Talent Show, which we talked about previously on this show. So I learned a lot about her at that event. We learned that she knows sit, that she knows lay down. She was okay with large crowds. She was okay with children coming up to her. She was okay with loud music, live music. She actually went up on stage with me and there were lots of bright lights. And she just kind of laid down and sat there. She took treats nicely. She did a lot of stuff that really showed off how well behaved she is. She doesn't really know her name very well. It is her name. She came in with that name. So changing her name wouldn't really be much of an issue. It's all about repetition, saying her name, getting her to recognize and know that that's her name. She does seem to respond to like other noises though, like if you whistle, she looks up. But she doesn't really respond to Tasha quite yet. She is 7 years old. She's a pit bull mix. She came to us as a stray, but based on our records here, dog licenses, microchipping information, we know that she has been previously owned. So she walks really nicely on leash. You know, here we never make guarantees about whether or not our dogs are house trained, but she didn't have any accidents out last night, although we were taking her out on a fairly regular basis and she would always go when we took her outside. She likes treats, so she's treat motivated. Randy just briefly was trying to get her to do paw or shake, and she pretty much caught on, you know, pretty quickly for the first try with a little bit of practice. She's going to be able to do a lot of stuff. She's very smart. She's very sweet. She loves to be petted. And she will just kind of sit down next to your feet. If you're having a conversation with people, she doesn't attention seek. She just kind of patiently sits down and lays there and waits for you to give her attention. But she will let you know if she needs something, if she needs to go out. She was alerting the volunteers last night so that she could get out, no accidents there. So she's got a lot of potential. She's very sweet. And because she's an older dog, she's gonna be calm like this. This is her, you know, her demeanor. She always has a smile on her face when you're walking past her kennel. All the other dogs right now seem to be barkers in the kennel environment. You get down to her cage, just quiet. She's just looking at you with a big smile on her face. So if you're interested in taking nice, sweet Tasha home with you, you want to make sure that you stop by and visit her at Frederick County Animal Control and Pet Adoption Center. Our next guest is Lucy, and Lucy is a little dog, but she thinks that she's a big dog. She is another one of our senior animals. She is 7 years old as well. Lucy has actually been in our care since January. When Lucy came in, she was previously owned. She had some mammary tumors and some other issues, so she stayed here with us for quite some time. We've resolved those. We had some surgery done for her. We've been working on training with some volunteers, and then she went to live in a foster home for a while. So we were able to get some more information about Lucy, and now she's back here on our adoption floor, and she's being made available for viewers and people to come in and possibly take her home. There are a lot of things that people need to be aware of before taking home Lucy. A lot of people come in and they are interested in small dogs, and so when they see Lucy, they immediately want to find out more about her. They think they want to take her home. As I mentioned earlier, Lucy had some mammary tumors. We removed most of those, but a couple were missed, and so they are still there. That is something that an adopter would have to talk to their vet about and consider whether or not they're just gonna leave those as they are, or if they want those to be removed as well. Other things that you need to be aware of with Lucy: she's got a lot of spunk. As I said, she thinks that she's a big dog. She can be nervous a little bit, but then she also doesn't always like other dogs. And she has some issues with resource guarding, things like her food and her toys and her people. As you can see, she's really attached to her toy right now. So those are all things that she would need training on. Lucy has a lot of potential, but she does need somebody to really put in the time and effort to train her properly. So you want to make sure that when you're coming in to look at Lucy, you are reading all of her paperwork, understanding that with her cuteness and her sweetness, she also has a little bit of sass there as well that you're going to have to be able to manage. As a senior, she would be eligible for our senior discount, so that reduction in the adoption fee can help you a little bit as far as further training and medical care for Lucy. Please stop by and visit with her if you are interested in making her a part of your family. Our next guest is Bella Fluff. We get so many Bellas, and we have so many Bellas in our care right now that we have to give them some middle names, and because of her fluffy look, Bella ended up as Bella Fluff. She is a 2 to 3 year old Portuguese water dog. Things to know about Portuguese water dogs. They are known as being hypoallergenic dogs. They don't shed. They are great swimmers. And this is also the same breed of dog that the Obama family has. So they have two of these at their home. Bella was brought to us fairly recently. She does have some energy. She still has that youthful exuberance. She likes to play with toys. She does get excited when she sees people in her kennel, and she runs up to the front of the cage. She barks. Sometimes she jumps up. It's mostly excitement. It's not really an aggression thing. All things to be aware of when you're coming in and looking at the dogs. With a lot of the dogs, once you take them out of their cages, their personalities kind of change a little bit. You can see the quieter side to them. In the kennels, they're trying to get your attention. They are excited to see people. They want to get out. They want to go out and play and walk. And once they're outside, they calm right down. The barriers can be an issue for some dogs. According to her previous owner, she's playful, she's energetic, she's friendly. She can be a little shy around other dogs, but she's used to riding in the car, getting her bath, going to the vet, getting her nails trimmed. They did mention that she is a jumper, which we've definitely seen here in the shelter environment. As with all the dogs, we have done a behavior assessment on her. Says that she's friendly and excited. When we've walked her past other dogs, she has no reaction. She can pull on her leash. She knows sit, which is great. But she's got a lot of energy, so you're going to have to be willing to train her and get her the exercise that she needs so that she is working off that energy in a positive way, keeping her mentally stimulated when she's going to be inside for any length of time with Kongs and other types of toys. Because just like your children, when your dog is bored, that's when they tend to get into trouble. So if you're interested in taking on a sweet little Bella Fluff here, you can stop by and visit her here in the shelter. We are open 6 days a week, Monday through Saturday. Check out our website, frederickcountymd.gov/FCAC, to find out what times the kennels are open on each of those days. Our next guest is Leslie, and yes, you have seen her before. She's been on the show previously. She had some interest, she had some applications, but they've fallen off. So she's still here, and so we want to give her another shot at her 15 minutes of fame. Maybe this will be the week that somebody, one of our viewers, sees her and decides to make her part of their family. Leslie is another one of our seniors. She's a 9-year-old lab mix. She was previously owned. She was brought to us for some personal issues that the owners were having. But according to them, she's lived with other dogs. She's lived with a cat. She's been around children from, newborns on up. So she's going to be a great family pet. She has experience with all the types of people, children, animals that, would typically be in a home. According to them, she walks well on leash, she's friendly, she's used to all those typical things, the riding in the car, the baths, vet checks, nail trims. they say that she does jump to kind of greet, and we've seen that here in the kennel. She'll kind of jump up and bark a little bit when people walk by, but once you take her out, as you can see now, she's very quiet. She loves to be petted. She, you know, just wants to get on the couch and cuddle up with you. They also let us know, her previous owners, that she knows sit and hug, which we've seen her do. She loves to give Randy hugs, and it is so cute. So if you stop by for a visit, you know, you're interested in adopting her and you take her outside to interact with her in one of the outdoor kennels or the play yard, see if she'll give you a hug as well. Just kind of melts your heart a little bit and makes you want to take her home even more. We do behavior assess all the dogs, as we've spoken of many times in the past. She's you know, doesn't have any issues with food aggression. They were unable to test her for guarding because she wasn't interested in the object that they gave her. She's got no reactions when handling her feet or her mouth. All in all, she's got a lot of great things going for her, which is common with older dogs. She is an orange color-coded dog here, which means that most people will be satisfied with her just the way she is, with no further training when they get her home. It is important to note that, like Tasha as well, she is Lyme positive, so you want to make sure that you're consulting with your vet, making sure that you're okay with taking on a dog that has that Lyme positive status. But if you do want to visit with Leslie or any of her friends here at Animal Control, you want to stop in and check their status. You can do that 6 days a week here at Frederick County Animal Control and Pet Adoption Center. Our next guest is our last guest before the break. This is Bella. She is a familiar face. Even though Lucy is actually our longest resident, having been here since January, Bella is the dog that's been on the adoption floor for the longest. She's been on the adoption floor since March 20th, and she just hasn't been able to find that perfect family for her yet. She's 1 to 2 years old. She did come to us as a stray, so we don't know very much about her, but she was microchipped, so at some point along the way, she must have been owned for somebody to go ahead and get her chipped and all that stuff. Because Bella has not really had a lot of manners training, she needs somebody who's willing to work with her on those things. Right now in our facility, we have some volunteers that have been working with her. So she now knows sit. She will do lay down. She's doing a pretty good starting point for a paw or a shake. When you walk by her kennel, Bella is always super happy to see people. She's got a big smile on her face. Her tail is always wagging. Her kind of signature pose in her kennel is she lies on her back, and then you just see her head's kind of up looking at you, and her tail's wagging. She likes to play with toys. She has a lot of great potential. There's a lot of great things about her. She's sweet. She's silly. She loves to cuddle. As you can see, she's treat motivated, and she's been able to be trained here in just the last month or so that she's been in our facility. So if you have more time to dedicate to her, obviously she could learn a lot more things. She does pull on her leash, which is why we have her in a harness. And she is also a bit of a chewer, which is why she has the metal leash, so that it makes it harder for her, obviously, to chew through those leashes. Other things that are important to know before stopping in to take a look at Bella, because she is a beautiful dog and she's very sweet and a lot of people are interested in her, but you want to make sure that you can take on what you're getting. She is not really a fan of small children, so she should go to a home with older children. You know, teenage children and up probably would be best for her, or an adult-only home. She also doesn't always like other dogs, which is why we have her in a different kind of area of the kennel, which is still visible to the public, but keeps her so that not as many dogs are walking by her in that kennel environment. So we have her as no small dogs, no cats. We do have a volunteer who has picked Bella up as a stray before and interacted with her. Outside of a kennel environment, she seemed to do okay with that volunteer's dogs, although because she is so strong and she is She plays a little bit rough. Those are things that you want to take into consideration as well. And that's going to wrap it up for this half of Pet Pals. The next half, we'll see five cats that are looking for their forever homes, three new faces and a couple of returning faces. And we'll also even things out a little bit with a bunch of male pets. So Randy won't be as outnumbered here in the next half of the show.
Frederick Green Homes Challenge is now online. Visit frederickgreenchallenge.org to sign up for a free account and start saving energy, saving money, and reducing your environmental impact. Learn about actions you can take from small to big, like upgrading your light bulbs, using water-saving devices, or installing a renewable energy system. Add actions to your to-do list, earn points for completing actions, and track your savings, all online. You can even post your story and learn from the experience of others. To get started, visit frederickgreenchallenge.org and click Take the Challenge.
Welcome back. As promised, we've got five great cats that are looking for their forever homes. And first up is Midnight. He is a very recent addition to the adoption floor. Even though he acclimated to shelter life, it's a little bit different when they're coming from the back out into the front. Yesterday, he was put out on the adoption floor. So he's getting used to that, and now he's in this room. So he's a little bit nervous right now because he's in a very new environment after being in another very new environment. But he is a very sweet cat. He is color-coded orange, which means that he's just your average cat. He wants to sit on your lap when he wants to sit on your lap. He wants to play when he wants to play, and he wants to be left alone when he wants to be left alone. Midnight is a beautiful black domestic short hair. He's 1 to 1.5 years old. He came in with the name Midnight. It's kind of obvious as to why he came in with that name. We won't change that name here when they come in with a name, but people who adopt our animals are always welcome to change their names. What we know about Midnight is that he's been around children, he's been around men and women. You're able to handle him. He's playful, energetic, friendly. Those are all things that the previous owner have said about Midnight. They also said that he claws at furniture. It's really important when you're taking a cat into your house that you train them like you would train your dog, or how you would teach your children right from wrong. The easiest way to do that with a cat is to use a spray bottle when they're doing things that you deem inappropriate in your house, just to spray them with that water. So if he's clawing at the furniture, you can do that. Sitting on the counter, you can do that. It's also important to provide them with things that they can scratch on. So he's gonna need scratching pads, posts in the house, those types of things. And then rewarding him when he's using the correct items to scratch on. Also trimming his nails is a good way to prevent him from doing any damage to your furniture, woodwork, those types of things. That's just part of owning a cat. It's basic cat care and maintenance to have those scratching posts around your house for them. But as he's a new addition, we're still learning a lot about him as time goes on. Stop by and visit with Midnight if you're interested in adding this beautiful cat to your home. Maybe during your visit you'll find out some information that might help us get him a better home sooner. This handsome brown tabby is Lincoln, and he's another one of our senior residents. He's 5 years old, so he's just now reaching that senior status. And what's being a senior at the shelter means, it means a reduction in your adoption fee. So animals that are 5 to 10 get a, are, 5 to 9, excuse me, get a reduction in their adoption fee of $20. Animals that are 10 to 14 get $40 off, and then 15 and up, they get $60 off. Not because they are worth less, but sometimes the older animals can be a little harder to adopt. Mm-hmm. So this gives people that incentive, helps with medical care, if anything that they need down the line. Most of our senior animals don't really need a lot. As far as Lincoln goes, he's a really healthy guy. But as animals age, just like people, they incur more medical expenses. So you want to make sure that you're prepared for those things down the line, that they may have some financial needs as far as their medical expenses go. According to his previous owners, Lincoln has been around all types of people, children, small animals. He can be a lap cat sometimes, which is pretty much how you can describe almost every cat. They all want to do things when they want to do it. Right now he seems pretty content sitting on Randy's lap, but he also wants to get down and explore this new space that he's in. You can see him looking around, taking it all in. The previous owner also let us know that he has a few favorite toys that he likes to play with. He loves the laser, and he likes to play with string. So those are great ways to engage him, get bond with him, also get him exercise, because cats need exercise as well. It does also say that he spooks with loud noises. So just being aware that if there are loud doors slamming or kids yelling, those types of things might startle him at first until he gets used to those things. And then again, like midnight before him, you want to make sure that he has a scratching pad, scratching post. It says that he does do some clawing, but that he uses his scratching pads and things like that that are provided to him. So if you're interested in adding this handsome guy to your family, you want to stop in and visit him here at Frederick County Animal Control and Pet Adoption Center. This handsome guy is Spike. I love Spike's name. Spike's got a very striking face. He has a lot of unique things about him, not just his markings. Spike is a tripod cat. So he's missing a portion of his one of his back legs, his left hind leg. So he's, a big guy walking around on three legs. It's important to know that when you take home a tripod cat, that they don't really need any special accommodations for them. They've learned throughout their lives how to make allowances for their disability, so to speak. He'll still be able to, get up on, jump on things if he wants to, go up and down the stairs, all of those types of things. He's already learned how to live with his situation, and he can handle that on his own. But because he is an older cat, as he gets older, he might need some additional maintenance. Things like arthritis can set in sometimes because they're putting more weight on their other limbs. So just things that you should be aware of. One of the most important things that when you're taking home a medium to long-haired cat, this guy here, Spike, is medium-haired, and we are noticing that he has a lot of mats. When you're taking on a long-haired animal, you want to make sure that you're giving him or her the proper grooming that they need. In order to resolve his mats, he's probably going to have to end up getting a lion cut or something like that down the line. But when you're taking them home, they need to be brushed more frequently than short-haired cats. If your cat doesn't enjoy that, you might want to consider taking them to the groomer so that they can get that done. Mats can be very painful for the animals, so we want to make sure that we're keeping them healthy and happy. It's part of normal cat maintenance when you have a cat who has fur like this. Another important thing that you want to know about Spike here is that he is front declawed. So anytime you have an animal that's front declawed, you definitely want to make sure that you're keeping him or her inside, not letting them go indoor, outdoor, especially since Spike has the added issue of having only three legs, that definitely would impair his ability to get away if he needed to. So you want to keep Spike inside and safe if you're thinking of adding him to your family. If you want to visit with Spike, you can stop by the shelter. We are located at 1832 Rosemont Avenue. Pretty Girl had a little bit of stage fright, so we've gone ahead and put her back into the safety and comfort of her cage. But Babar is here. Babar is a 1 to 2 year old domestic short hair. He's white and black, and he came to us as a stray, so we gave him his name, and we're still learning things about him. He's got great markings. He's kind of got the salt and pepper thing going on in his black fur, and he's got the cute little pink nose. As you can see, he's shedding a little bit. Shedding is part of having a cat, but you can help maintain, control that a little bit if you are brushing your cat. If you know that your cat's a shedder, giving it a brushing more frequently than maybe you would if it's not so much of a shedder. And while they're here in the shelter, we don't really brush them because we're concerned about the germs. It's hard to sanitize those brushes. So when you take Babar home, if you decide to add him to your family, you want to make sure that you're giving him a good brushing, you know, at least once a week, if not more. Some cats really enjoy that. It's a great way to bond with them. If he likes it, then you could do it every day if he wanted that and enjoyed that. If not, you want to try to, you know, at least get it done once a week or so. Because he's a stray, as I mentioned earlier, we don't know a lot about him. He can be very playful. He's also, you know, pretty mellow. We've given him the distinction of, you know, orange color-coded cat. So he does things when he wants to do them. You know, initially he was pretty, you know, content sitting on Randy's lap, and now he's decided he wants to be a little more curious and get down and see what's going on. He's 1 to 2 years old, so he's still kind of got some kitten energy in him, but he's old enough that his personality is pretty set. He's gonna be who he's gonna be. And when you get him home, you'll definitely notice more of his personality coming out. The shelter can be a little stressful for the animals, so you know, how he is here is a good indicator, but when you get him home, his personality will really kind of expand, and he'll show you more aspects of who he really is. So that's going to wrap it up for the animals that we have on the show today, but I do want to talk about some upcoming events that we have. On April 29th, we are going to be at the Mid-Maryland Petapalooza at the fairgrounds. We're going to be there all day with our focus group. We're going to have some adoptable animals and all of the information about the shelter in our focus group that you could possibly be interested in. So we can talk to you about how to adopt. We can talk to you about volunteering. We can talk to you about donations. We can talk to you about specific animals. Anything that you might be interested in, we'll be there to answer your questions. So it's a great event if you are an animal person. There's going to be a lot of other vendors that are going to be there. There's going to be, you know, vendors that sell different things, sometimes people things, sometimes, you know, dog beds, dog collars, all of that type of stuff. And then we are also going to be at two Bark in the Park events upcoming in May. We are going to be at Bark at the Park on May 10th with at Key Stadium at Nimio Field there for the Keys Bark in the Park. And then we are also going to be in available with a table at the Bark in the Park on May 13th at Utica District Park through Parks and Rec here. We're gonna have some adoptable dogs there, and that is a pet-friendly event, as is the Keys game. So you just wanna make sure that you're doing a little research there, looking up those events, making sure that you're filling out any paperwork that you need to fill out in order to be able to bring your pet with you to those events. And then lastly, Memorial Day weekend, we are going to have our open house here. And we want to invite everyone to come. We're going to have food and games and some vendors that we work with. The shelter is going to be open, so you can stop by and visit with some of the animals and see what we're all about. And so that's a great opportunity, again, to learn more about the shelter. If you're interested in any of those events, you can find more information in the event section of our Facebook page. Just look facebook.com/FCAC and then click on the events bar there, and it'll take you to any of those events, and there'll be some more detailed information there. We do want to thank everybody for watching, and we'll see you back here next week with more adoptable pets.